Is that how you introduce someone?
No, Alex was asking you questions. Mate.
Yeah, but that's an hour conversation.
Right.
So there was an agenda here to portray me a certain way.
Yeah, portray you? You portray yourself in your own way.
No, like a
dick.
My question to the producers is, why is it okay for the women to continue to disrespect the guys like that and you not say or do anything about it? We had Rochelle and Orson, the way she dragged that man for filth. We had Sasha, Polly drag Alex for filth. We had the girls attack Luke last week. Nothing was done. And now we have Amy and her friends dragging Luke for filth. And no one is doing anything about it. I can only imagine if tables were turned and if it was the guys doing the same thing, would everybody be quiet? Or would there be millions and millions of complaints to Ofcom? Make it make sense? Anyway, hey there, thanks for stopping by. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe, click the like button, turn on the notification bell for when I upload new videos, and definitely leave a comment. In this episode, I'll be reviewing Married at First Sight, Season 9, Episode 29. Oh my God, how can a season have so many unlikable women? Seriously, how can it? Okay, last season we were saying maybe it's the edit for people like Tasha, but this season it can't be everybody's edit. It really can't. It really can't. And Amy is the next one going onto the pile of the crappy, you know, ladies. So she goes home with Luke to Maidstone. And from the moment she enters this house, she was already looking for problems. That's my opinion. I don't think she expected this house to be like that. The difference is last season with Peggy, when she went to her husband's house, she fell in love with her husband's house. That made her fall in love, and she decided to recommit on final vows. And yet for Amy, I'm going to truly believe that Amy, something happened between Amy and Adam during partner swap. That's my opinion. Something happened with the two of them, whether they were a bit naughty, frisky, or whatever happened, because their attitude leaving partner swap has been totally different, in the sense that now Amy is looking for any and every single problem. Luke had a picture on his fridge. Yes, it was cut. Yes, that's it. You don't need to know who was there on the other side. Is if that was a current person, or if he was in a relationship with you when he cut the picture, then I want to know who was that. If it's an ex, I do not care. If it's a fling, I do not care. That's his business. Why was she interrogating him? She was looking for an excuse to say, oh, he lied about this, or this, that, and the other. What, did he go into his house first before she went in and cut it off? Did the producer see it, and did they tell her to push him for that? What is it? I don't get the big deal. Yes, he told a white lie. Yes. So what does she want to do? Pack her bags and go home. And another one that sits on the counter. Seriously, you're coming into the house with your clothes from outside. You're not even sitting on the city sofa couch. You're straight onto the counter. Why? So that was something she had to kick off about, that because she wasn't happy. He told me a white lie. He's not honest. I want to see the real you. She had already told him in the car, will I get to see the real you? And it's like, the two of you have been married for a couple of weeks. If you haven't seen the real him or started to see glimpses of the real him, then maybe you haven't been looking. Maybe you haven't been looking. And I think their cultural differences are playing a big part in this relationship, because the following morning he takes her to this sort of venue where they normally hold weddings, because he knows she's a wedding or event planner, and he's saying to her, you know, there's a big park for you to walk your dog, you know, you can plan weddings here, and also, you know, humans can get exercise. It could be taken any way. It could be he's talking about someone he has put on a bit of weight and they need to exercise. He didn't say anything about the bedroom. I didn't hear him say anything about the bedroom. Is it me? Did somebody else hear him imply the bedroom? No. So why she had her backup? Only she knows. She was looking for a reason to be upset with him. She found it, and she's going to hold on to it. Instead of yelling at him and degrading him and devaluing him and being derogatory, she can pack her bags and go home. She can do a Kieran. She doesn't need to be around this man and continue to dehumanize him just for her to feel better about herself. I don't like it. I think these girls have decided that any publicity is good publicity. So they've decided to play the villain in their marriages. That way they get more airtime. I think they've realized that this is the only way they can get more airtime. Or they were just this evil. They were pretending to be nice people all along. Anyway, I digress. Then you have Ross and Sasha go to Sasha's house in Warsaw. She says she misses her cat. She's excited to see her cat. And I felt like, Here it is. I felt like she was trying to play it up how she missed the cat. I think she was expecting a reaction, like, you know, or to sort of have a moment like Ross had when he went home. And the cat couldn't be bothered, really. It couldn't be bothered. It didn't even seem excited to see her. Maybe she needs to get a dog because dogs are more expressive. So maybe the dog would have been pouncing up and down and that would have made, you know, Ross see that her dog really missed her, because that cat, I don't think, missed her at all. Or is it just me? Or is it just because she's not one of my favorite people? I don't know. You have Kieran and Christina. Apparently, they went home separately. I'm going to say this. I feel like Christina and Kieran broke up. I feel like they broke up, or they wanted to break up, but production have told them you can't break up. You have to push it till the very end, because there's no reason for them to go to homestays if they're not living together. What, they're just going to go and see their homes and that's it. Make it make sense. It doesn't make sense. I don't get why they needed to go home if they were not going to visit each other's homes. What's the purpose of going home? You have Christina walking her dog. You have Kieran running to meet his dog. And it's like, what's the purpose of them going home? Or what's the purpose of even showing them to us? Because it's not going to make any difference at all. So you have Sasha's mom and dad come over to see her and Ross. Obviously, they are at Sasha's place. They seem excited to see one another. I think Sasha's reactions were over-exaggerated. I think after she wants to be the one who's more expressive in the relationship, and the idea of seeing Ross and his daughter and how excited the daughter was and how moving that was, I think she's decided to over-exaggerate her reaction to seeing her dad. Because when her parents came to see her at the in-laws week, we didn't get this reaction. Suddenly, we're getting this reaction after seeing Ross's daughter and his sort of family's reaction to him coming home. That's my opinion. Maybe I'm hypercritical of her, but hey, it is what it is. They have a sit down because the parents are saying, if we hear that she's not happy, we're going to have a problem with Ross. And it's like, if only you knew how your daughter has been behaving, how she's been showing her behind on national TV, you wouldn't be saying that. Anyway, they have a sit down with Sasha and Ross. Sasha tells them that, you know, they went to see Ross's family and she really was touched by him and his daughter's reactions at seeing one another. And so this has made her question whether she's still open to moving to Manchester, and she's no longer 100%. And so it's like, so you're not 100% moving to Manchester because of your Ross's reaction to seeing his daughter. And also you're now talking about his temper. When did this come in about the temper? When did it come in? And did you tell your parents why he reacted the way he reacted? So are you saying you're afraid for your, you fear for your life then, that if he gets upset and he loses his temper again, then you're not going to be safe? What do you mean? Make it make sense. I don't get that. I think she's just looking for an excuse as to why she wants to sort of stay in Warsaw. You had Ross leave them for a bit. And so she's having a conversation with her parents, and both her parents are saying, we don't want you to move. And it's like, make it make sense. You have a 30-year-old and you have a 3-year-old. And so you want someone to move and leave their 3-year-old just because your 30-year-old can't be away from mommy and daddy. Make it make sense. I don't get that. I really don't. And I don't understand it. And I find that very selfish and being very self-centered, in my opinion. I feel like she knew this man lived in Manchester. She knew he had a young child. She promised him that she would move up. She told her parents she was moving up, went up, realized that she wouldn't be his priority number one. Now she's changed her mind and she's looking for excuses. This is the first we've heard of it. So make it make sense. Anyway, I digress. We then have Amy and Luke. They go to Amy's house, to visit Amy's house. And for, I wish they would just stop. I wonder what happened after that clash at Luke's place. I wonder whether Amy was put up in a hotel and Luke had to go back to his place on his own. Because Luke is saying, you know, I'm ready to start afresh. I'm going to be on my best behavior because things didn't work out as well when we went to my homestay. So I'm going to try and do better this time. She's got one of those little sausage dogs. Luke, you know, really tried and went on the floor to sort of meet the dog and sort of play with the dog. And she said, oh, I don't like it. He's tonguing my dog. Is this? At least he went on the floor. I don't like dogs. So I wouldn't have come in. I wouldn't have. I'm not a dog person. I've been chased by a dog before. Never been bitten. Touch wood. I don't want to be bitten by a dog. I've worked where I've seen dog bites, cat bites, bat bites. I can't. Anyway, so she's complaining that he's kissing my dog, he's tonguing my dog, why is he doing that to my dog? And it's like, well, maybe you shouldn't have brought your dog into this situation then. Maybe you should have kept your dog off camera. How about that? maybe you should have done that, and that would have made more sense. Well, she's showing him round, then she's showing him up to her bedroom because she lives with her mommy. I don't know whether her daddy is there. We didn't hear that bit. And then they're sort of looking at pictures of her old picture and the current and the way she looks now. And Luke is like, wow, you had a glow up. It is a glow up. If it wasn't a glow up, she wouldn't have had the work done. If she had issues with herself, she felt she was ugly. So she went for lip fillers. She had fillers in her cheeks. She's had whatever else she's had done. She said she had her teeth done. Everything she's had done was to try and make herself look prettier. Let's be honest. I feel like she looked way better before she had all the work done. And because Luke said she had a glow up, she got upset at that. Oh, what are you trying to say? Luke said you looked a bit bloated. He didn't tell her the truth that you looked a bit chubbier in the picture. That was the truth. He said you looked a bit bloated. She looked chubby in the picture. Let us be honest. Let us call a spade a spade. Her body image issues are now playing a part in this relationship because she's looking for excuses as to why she should have a problem with look. I think if she had come to the experiment the way she looked before all the work, I don't think all the people, including Adam, would have said she's as pretty as she is or would have been as attracted to her as she is. And she knows that. So for her to suddenly have an issue with look, I do not get it. I really don't. I think she's projecting her own insecurities. The following morning is the same old thing. They have a clash again because Luke and her dog are kissing and she doesn't like that. And she thinks that's disrespectful. And Luke said to her, I understood where he was coming from because I'm someone who likes to talk through examples. And he's saying to her, in a relationship, you have to decide whether you want to focus on the good or the bad. It's like if being in a room and looking and choosing to focus on the positive or the negative. I could easily lie here and look at the mold in the corner, but I choose not to. I choose to look at the beauty elsewhere. She got upset. Why are you pointing out the mold in the area? It's not mold. It's bad paintwork. It's mold. It's mold. She can go to TikTok shop and buy those mold thingies, or she can go to Costco. Anywhere she wants, she can buy those things, place them in the house, and hopefully that will absorb the damp in her house, and she doesn't need to be upset with Luke. Oh, yeah, you know, you're talking badly about my mom and dad's house. Why did you bring him then? Why did you bring them? Why didn't you rent a room somewhere and bring him there? Make it make sense? Oh, my God, I'm so upset with her. And then you have Christina and Kira, and Christina meets up with her mom. She's having conversations with her mom and just saying to her mom, you know, I know you were looking forward to seeing me and Kieran, but we've been having problems and Kieran has really been struggling in regards to how does he sort of move on from where he is. He's not sure whether we will last long term. I see a future with Kieran. I see us lasting forever. So I have to wait for him to decide what he wants to do. And it's like, that's the problem. You shouldn't be giving him all the power. You should ask yourself, do I see this working or do I not? Do I want someone who's always questioning whether he feels about me the same way I feel about him? If you don't, keep it stepping. You will find your own person. There's no point in you sitting there and waiting like you're at a bus stop waiting for the next bus just because someone has decided that he doesn't want you. As I said before, I feel like Christina and Kieran broke up and the producers decided to drag them along for as long as they could because they knew they'd painted them in this sort of bright light that they were fan favorites. So they were going to push them for as long as they can, because how long can we continue the storyline of Kieran making his mind? This is now the second week. He needs to make up his mind. Kieran meets up with his stepdad and his brothers and is sort of telling them that the wedding was amazing, but Christina told me she had PMDD, and it's like, you know, PMS times 100. And so when they went to the retreat, it happened, and he doesn't know whether he can deal with that. And it's like, if you love someone, you'll do anything and everything. He says he's been in relationships where he's been the giver and is tired of giving. He wants also to be given. And it's like, Christina didn't say she wouldn't be there for him. If she struggles for 2 weeks, then the other 2 weeks she's there for him. Why can't he do that? It's either he doesn't love her anymore or something happened at the retreat that they've chosen not to air or chosen not to discuss, or he has found somebody else. Which is it? So either he doesn't like her anymore, something happened at the retreat, or he's found somebody else. My money is on he's found somebody else and he wants to move on, but he doesn't know how to navigate that. He doesn't know how to navigate that. This is why he's carrying on and coming up with silly excuses, unless it's been put as part of his storyline. So Luke and Amy, I feel like Amy is public enemy number one this week. She is public enemy number one. Her behavior is uncalled for. She started off last week and she's just got worse with every single thing, because since wife swap, she's been looking for excuses as to why things are not going to work between her and Luke. And now she's found an excuse and she's holding onto it for dear life, because they go clothes shopping and, you know, they're sort of looking at clothing and she brings up the issue about the mold. And it's like, seriously, have we not moved on from this? Did he sort of hurt you that much that he complained about the mold? If you're that offended about the mold, why not get a stepladder and clean it anyway? Anyway, they go off camera, or they assume they're off camera. The cameras have been turned off. And Luke is saying to her, why did you have to bring that up? You didn't need to bring the comment about the mold up. We could have discussed anything else outside of that. And she went, because my mom is going to see it and she's going to feel some type of way, so we had to bring it up. And he's like, but it wasn't necessary. We discussed it already. We don't need to keep bringing it up. And I don't think Luke has got an on-camera persona and an off-camera persona. I think he is who he is all the time. I think he might be trying to tame himself because he knows that it offends his wife every time he behaves or he says anything inappropriate. They then went to meet up with her friends. Her friends seemed to like him on sight. So, well, the one that hadn't met him. And I think because she liked him, this is why Amy, as soon as Luke stood up to go and get drinks, decided to say all the negative stuff. And the audacity. Luke didn't just come into that house and say, oh, everything is beautiful except for the mold. They were having a conversation about negativity. And Luke said to her, you need to decide what you want to focus on in a relationship. You need to either focus on the positives or the negatives. Because if we're going to focus on the positives, it's like entering this room and I look around this room and I choose to focus on the negatives. I could say there's mold in the corner, which there is. And so for her to go to her friends and say, oh, he said your mom's house is beautiful, but there's mold in the corner. Of all the things he said, that's what you picked up on. She was looking for an excuse. She wanted her friends to grill him, because as soon as he was on his way back, she told them, make sure you ask him plenty of questions. Ask him questions. Ask him questions. Then they started, what do you do for a living? I work in a prison. I run an education program. What else? He spoke about all his other hobbies, because he's a man with multiple talents. What else? What else? Eventually, he had to tell them he does butler in the buff, but he's only done it twice this year. Oh, why didn't you say that? And you also lie. And it's like, seriously, why are we doing this to this man? Why are we doing this? And I don't get how production continues to sit there and watch as these ladies are so derogatory and very disrespectful to the men. Are they waiting for the man to sort of retaliate? Because all the men bar Alex haven't said anything. We had Rochelle and Orson, and Rochelle kept dragging Orson and he didn't say anything. And then we had Sasha come for Alex with Polly, and Alex had to stand on business for them to step back. And I give it to Luke for standing on business, not disrespectfully, but he actually told them, you're trying to assassinate my character by saying all these negative things about me. You have an agenda and this is what it is. And they had an agenda. The agenda was to embarrass him and to humiliate him. And so that's what they were trying to do. So kudos to him for sticking up for himself. Kudos to him for sticking up for himself. And he took off his ring and refused to stand up. And, oh, I'm so upset. I'm so seething. You are seething mad because somebody's told you there's mold in your room. A grown-ass woman like you can't get a ladder or a chair and step up and get something, bleach or whatever, spray it off and wipe it off. Get a mold a dehumidifier and put it in your room and stop mold accumulating. You can't do that. Instead, you're going to throw a fit and a tantrum. I don't get it. I think she was putting on a performance. I think she's decided to move on with Adam. And so she's looking for a way to sort of turn people away from Luke. That way she doesn't look bad for leaving Luke. Well, she looks terrible, in my opinion. Can someone explain to me why Sasha needed to take Ross to a field? Please make it make sense, because to me it's not making sense. Because she took him to a field and she was, oh, we used to come here. It's got a lot of sentiment to me. There's an ice cream van where you can use a card. I think she was trying to play on those girls where the ice cream van wouldn't take a card and only needed cash. And so for me, I didn't get it. It seemed like she was trying to reenact everything that happened at Ross's homestay, because Ross took her to a park. Ross took her to meet his mom and daughter. And now she's taking him to meet her grandparents. Well, her grandma and her aunts and I think cousins or something. I didn't get to read who the other person was. And for me, I don't get it. I really don't. I like that the family, the aunt, I think, was practicing sign language to ask Ross about love. But the fact that she's now suddenly so adamant that she can't move, she wants to be close to her family because of Ross's temper. And it's like, why are you throwing him under the bus in front of your family? Why are you disrespecting him? Why is it suddenly now a big deal? Because after that comment, the two of you made up and you attacked Alex and nothing was wrong with his temper. And suddenly now you're upset about his temper and you don't feel safe going to Manchester in case something goes wrong. And her mom and dad to say, we don't want her to leave us. Then she shouldn't get married then. She shouldn't get married. How about that? She shouldn't get married. She should stay at home with mommy and daddy until, you know, it's time for her to leave this world. Because what do you mean you need to be there to support her? What support are you going to give her? And she, Manchester and Warsaw, I don't think are that far apart. I think somebody said it's about an hour and a half or so. So you can always drive up, or she can drive down if she misses you. You want this man to leave his daughter because you are afraid to let go of your 30-year-old. How about a 3-year-old? Make that make sense. I don't get it, and I don't understand it, and I don't understand the hoopla. Sadly, my patience with Sasha has gone out the window, followed by Amy. She's right behind Sasha. And so I don't have any empathy for her. I think she's doing this for attention because she needs a storyline and she has no one to fight with because Luke is not there at the moment and Alex has gone home. Anyway, thanks guys for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And click the link in my video to watch my review from episode 28. Bye guys!